हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू माय क्लास। सो टुडे इन दिस क्लास आई एम गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू द रिमेनिंग पार्ट्स ऑफ द चैप्टर विच वी वर डिस्कसिंग इन द लास्ट क्लास। व्हाट इज द नेम ऑफ अवर चैप्टर? द फंडामेंटल यूनिट ऑफ लाइफ। द फंडामेंटल यूनिट ऑफ लाइफ। So in the last class we saw the various cells in human body, these cells we saw, and we learned that the organisms which has only one cell are known as unicellular organisms, and the organisms which has many cells are known as multicellular organisms. So humans have millions and trillions of cells. Will have different kinds of cell. As you can see in the picture, there is a different blood cell, smooth muscle cell, bone cell, etc., etc. So, and the shape and size of the cell are related to the specific function they perform. All know that amoeba is made up of only one cell, but its shape is not exact. It keeps changing its shape. So we can say in some cases the shape of the cell is not the same. It could be like more or less fixed for a particular type of a cell. Understood? And nerve cell have a typical shape, and each of the cell has the capacity to perform certain basic functions. So every cell हैज द कैपेसिटी, तो हर सेल में कैपेसिटी होती है कि वो बेसिक फंक्शन परफॉर्म कर सके, विच आर द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ ऑल द लिविंग फॉर्म्स, ऑल द लिविंग ऑर्गेनिजम्स। वी नो दैट दे परफॉर्म अ बेसिक फंक्शन, बट हाउ डज दे परफॉर्म द बेसिक फंक्शन? लिविंग सेल बेसिक फंक्शन कैसे परफॉर्म करता है? We have seen the multicellular organisms. They have so many cells connected or divided. As you can see, these are the cells of the onion peel. So it is not unicellular organism cell, it is multicellular, means it has lot of cells and they are divided. ये अलग अलग divide किए हुए हैं, but एक से एक attached है, बहुत सारे cells है, connected है, पार्टीशन होके। एंड इन ह्यूमन्स बॉडी ऑल्सो देर आर मिलियंस एंड ट्रिलियंस ऑफ सेल्स। द डिफरेंट पार्ट्स ऑफ द ह्यूमन बॉडी परफॉर्म द डिफरेंट फंक्शन, वी ऑल न्यू इट वेरी वेल। लाइक फॉर एग्जाम्पल, वी कैन से ह्यूमन बॉडी हैज अ हार्ट टू पंप द ब्लड थ्रू आउट द बॉडी। यस, वी हैव अ डाइजेस्टिव सिस्टम टू परफॉर्म द डाइजेशन, एक्सक्रेटरी सिस्टम, सो लाइक दैट। So as I said, there is division of labor in multicellular organism. In the same way, there are division of labor in the single cell also, unicellular organism also. So each and every cell has some components which perform different activities. So there are some different components inside the cell which are known as organelles. And each organelles means the cell organelles perform a special function, such as they make new material in the cell, clearing up the cell. So it clears the cell by removing waste material from the cell, like that, and so on. The small components which are present in the cell are known as organelles, and because of these organelles only cell can live and it can be able to perform all the activities. Understood, students? Because of the organelles which are present inside the cell, all the activities can be done. ये सारे ऑर्गेनेल्स को ही मिलाकर बनता है सेल। सो दीज ऑर्गेनेल्स टुगेदर कॉन्स्टिट्यूट अ बेसिक यूनिट विच इज नोन एज सेल। And one more thing, all the organelles in all the cell in means different different cells are the same. हर organelles मतलब चाहे कौन से भी cell में हो वो same होते हैं. वो कौन सा भी function perform करे means no matter what their function is or what organisms they found in, but all the organelles inside the cell are similar. Let's moving on with our next topic. What is the topic? What is a cell made up of? What is a cell made up of? What is the structural organization of a cell? Structural organization of a cell. Just now we studied that all the organelles together makes the cell. Means organelles बहुत होते हैं cell के अंदर, वो organelles ही मिलकर cell बनता है. How is a cell organized? All know that whenever we want to identify the cells or cells parts, what we do, we see through the microscope so that we can see it clearly. And we get to know the three features in almost all in every cells. What are the three features? We studied plasma membrane. और middle part में क्या होता है? Nucleus. And the remaining part is cytoplasm. We have studied it, so just consider it as a cell, and this will be nucleus, and this remaining part will be cytoplasm. Surrounding is known as plasma membrane. Understood? So these three things we find in the every cell whenever we see through it the microscope. So because of all these features inside the cells, all the activities can be done. I can say interaction of the cell with the environment are possible due to these features.